Everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time for another solo queue silliness here on the channel. Today, I'm going to be returning as the good old Lich King, Arthas, who is someone that I actually have been, I've been having an itch at playing again since the last video, especially since I've seen how much improved he is. I just wanted to play Arthas again. I am going to be playing him a little bit more DPS oriented instead of tanky oriented. On our team today, we have Lili, Diablo, Illidan, Nova taking on Abathur, Raynor, Diablo, Nova, and Tyrone. Good old Tyrone. So we have a pretty decent team. We've got two tanks, and we do have Lili for support, and we have a good DPS. Or I guess normally you would have a good DPS in Nova, but of course this is solo key silliness, so we have no idea what to expect. And Arthas, like I said, I've actually had a really strong desire to be playing as Arthas again. If you notice, they also changed the way that these bushes are shaped now. So it is going to be Diablo and Nova up in the top lane here, along with Abathur. Go back and toggle that off. So Diablo came back up to the top lane, as well as Lili, and down goes Diablo, first blood. That goes their Diablo, I should say. Of course, I missed Nova there with the Hungry Cold. And whoa, Jimmy, where are you coming from, Jimmy? I don't know what Raynor was doing there, but oh, I even grabbed that was even Nova, yeah, that was a real Nova. And that was a really good Hungry Cold by me, if I do say so myself. So we are already up by a couple kills. Illidan, unfortunately, did die. And Diablo, oh, come on, Diablo. Diablo, unfortunately, our Diablo saved the other Diablo. And he's going to go with a lift up on me. I know that that's coming. Here comes Nova. As well as Tyrone. Also known as Tyrande. Some people may be wondering, how can you call it Tyrone? Well, this is something that Idra got me to start saying, and I can't not call it Tyrande Whisperwind Tyrone at this point, just because it's so funny. So even after we were starting up by 4-1, the enemy team still was actually ahead of us in levels, because that makes sense. I have also not been using Frostborn Hungers. Frostborn Hungers super duper good when you are in direct contact. Oh, come on, Diablo. Second time Diablo has saved someone getting a little too overzealous there with the moves. I really wish that he would stop doing that, but what can you do? So I do see Frostborn Hungers there, and I did get a lot of bonus damage on Raynor. Mines are indeed up. And I am just going to get a little bit of XP. We don't have any XP coming in from bottom lane, unfortunately. We'll go down into the mines as well to join Nova and Illidan. Restores more mana. That sounds great. I should be able to get Diablo. We both kill each other. Actually, no. Nova was the one who killed me. I was able to kill Diablo, but then I got tapped by Nova. So, not really worth it. I did kill Diablo, but he's died many times already in this game. Our Diablo is now chasing Nova with Tyrande doing a lot of damage. Diablo's not going to make it. Lili, unfortunately, will also probably die. Oh, maybe not. And, oh, Jimmy. Jimmy barely escaping there. So Lili will not die. Yeah, man, Arthas is super duper fun to play. He's way more fun to play than he used to be. Arthas, by the way, for those of you who did not know, used to be just absolutely terrible. About as bad as Diablo used to be. Diablo is now considered one of the better characters. If you're looking for a decent tank along with a good wave clear, Diablo's got it going on. Our golem is significantly better than theirs. So we're gonna use for the Tempest's name. Saw that one coming from Tyrone a mile away. Now goes Abathur. A hero has abandoned the battle. There's one of Abathur's poison nests, which I will take out before it clears our wave. I did see Nova. There she is. That's gotta be Nova. And I Don't know if I'm going to be able to get away. Oh, the owl killed me? How do you get killed by an owl, Arthas? Come on, Arthas. Runetap's super duper good. Frostborn Hungers deals area damage. I don't see how that's better than Runetap. Our Brave Golem is up and is waddling his way over to our top lane. Or over to the enemy's top lane, I should say. So our Golem is going down like a sack of potatoes because it's getting hit by not only the turrets, but Tyrande and Nova. I was able to take down Nova there without having to use recoil. Yeah, I don't know if those disconnects that you see, I don't know if that's actually people disconnecting or not. There's that since the newest patch, the Phantom disconnect bug has been rampant again. Here comes the enemy Diablo. I'm pretty sure I killed that poisonous. This is the real Diablo, by the way. It's not being played by a bot. I'm gonna cancel Frozen Tempest here. See you later, Diablo. Easy kill. Enemy Avatar is trying his best to hold the fort. And down goes our Grave Golem. I still think that we're going to be able to take this down. I'm gonna try to tank as much damage as possible here. Gotta love the Lich King, man. Gotta love Arthas. Arthas was not one of my favorite characters in the Warcraft universe. That would be... Who is my favorite character in the Warcraft universe? I've always liked Chen. I've always liked Illidan. Speaking of Illidan, using the hunt for almost killing himself on Nova. It's very good. But Arthas never really struck me as like one of my favorite, I love to see this character type thing. He's always kind of been, I don't want to say boring because it's a really interesting dynamic to have him once being the prince and then now he's like the Lich King. Which of course, for those of you who play WoW, you realize that that's no longer the case. Mild spoiler warning there, but I don't know if Blizzard plans on using the World of Warcraft canon in the Warcraft canon. I feel like Blizzard probably won't do that. Hopefully WoW is more like it's just kind of like an alternate universe type thing, but I have a feeling. I don't know. Yeah, I've always liked Chen Stormstout. He's always been a very, very awesome character. Karen Bloodhoof is another one that I've always really enjoyed. I thought Karen had some really, really interesting things. Should be able to take down Diablo, which we did. There comes the... You can see the orbital command coming out from Nova. Jimmy's going to try to demount Illidan, which he did. So the mines will be open up in 8 seconds. There's no reason for you to go back.
The damned shall soon return.
So Illidan is already down here with Arthas. Heroes. And you want to talk about a weird team there, a weird tag team, Illidan and Arthas. For those of you who know anything about the Warcraft 4, you would know that probably would never ever happen. And that's where I'll stop the lore talk because I know how people can get. Oh my god, there's a lore. So interesting to know here, for those of you who have not seen the game since the newest patch, they actually relocated the Grave Golem in the mines. Oh hey, it's Diablo. Hello Diablo, hello friend! Illidan once again using the hunt, which I don't know why. Normally I would say, especially as someone who plays Illidan all the time, that the hunt is nowhere near as good as Metamorphosis. So down goes Tyrone. We should be able to get Diablo as well. Nova went down. Down goes Diablo, and Abathur will get a kill on Lili most likely. I think Spell Shield's gonna be better than that. Lili's actually still alive. Very nice indeed. So I did my job, I tanked at 1v4 and set him up for a whole lot of kills, hopefully. Because Avatar wasting Diablo's ult. And everyone, by the way, thank you everyone who watched the last episode where I played as Avatar. Avatar is super duper good. Everyone was really excited to see Avatar play. And I love me some Avatar. Even when good old H the Husky Husky's playing as Avatar, I still like watching him. down and see if I can help out. That's alright, Cindragosa just needed to, she just needed time out in the sun. That's all she really cared about. So Arthas, super duper good tank, especially for this fight, with Rune Tap, if I can just keep him alive. Golem is going to be quite massive. I'm going to go back, turn off. I'll turn off Frozen Tempest in a second. There we go.
Torment.
Regen a little bit of mana here, and we are off and running. So far, it's been a very even game, but our team has been absolutely mollywhopping in kills, and able to land the Hungry Cold on Diablo. Avatar is there to save him. That ult is considered not the best ult for Diablo. Arthas would not be dying to the owl once again. So go back and heal here. So they have two Diablos on bot, and their Grave Golem is pushing. Our Grave Golem should make it a long way. It's a 94 Skull Golem. I am going to use Cindragosa on the Grave Golem. There he goes. There we go. So the Golem got a little bit, probably arguably a little bit further than it should have, but we were able to stop it. And now I'm going to go assist Arkham. Let's go to Mortal Coil. Go for Death Knight Arthas. You see that even after fighting at 4 versus 1 and tanking all the turret damage, our Golem is still up. I'm just trying to help push our Golem a little bit. So that is able to. I was able to land it on Jimmy there, but unfortunately, we don't have any damage to follow it up with. So much damage to Tarande. Can I get a heal, Lili? Can I get a heal, Lili?
A hero has abandoned.
Oh, what? The Immortal Coil didn't heal me there? Well, I ended up getting assist for Rainer, but I don't know why the Immortal Coil did not heal me. Okay. Well, I guess I probably should have self-cast that on myself, but I was not expecting me to die in between the coil going out and the healing. So we're up 23-9. Again, I don't know if the kill counter can actually be trusted. I'm not sure if Blizzard has fixed it since the last time we looked at that. It seems that they have, but I still am not going to trust the kill counter in this game just because it seems like it's hard to really define what is a kill, what's a takedown. A takedown is kind of like a group kill, I guess. But I don't know how the scoreboard differentiates between the two, so I just don't pay attention to it. All it really matters is map objectives, and even truth be told, levels don't even really matter in this game that much anymore. Unless if you're down by like 10 or something. So mines will open up in 18 seconds. I am going to shut off Frozen Tempest. Frozen Tempest again is Arthas's that's his best jungling slash wave clearing ability.
Are you prepared to fight the undead?
Looks like Avatar's actually invading this. There we go. So the mines are back up, and I am.
Did you hear that clattering?
Go right back into it.
I believe they're hungry.
What's nice about Frozen Tempest or Frostborn Hungers is that it also resets, obviously, the basic swing, the basic attack here. So I completely whiff on the Hungering Cold. Oh, Diablo! This Diablo, though. I cannot count how many times our Diablo has saved enemy champions from picking them up, and either throwing them out of the range of one of my moves, or picking them up, or just pushing them out of my range. Either way, that did not work out. That would have been better if Diablo had just not been there. So Illidan, no longer all that good of a tanky character to take out the Grave Golem. He used to be great back in the day for tanking. Lili gives him some heals. I'm still down for the 20 seconds. Lili saying that he has no mana, so that's also a good sign for Illidan. And hopefully they can. Whoa, there, mouse. Hopefully they can take down the Grave Golem. Looks like if they swap back and forth with the taunts, that should be okay. Not that they can taunt, but you can talk about it. There we go. Oh man, so it's going to be a 99 Skull Golem versus their one Skull Golem, man. That is a very good thing. So I am going to chase Nova out of here. Avenger coming to save her. I was able to get the slowdown on her. Kill steal there. It's alright. Because kills don't matter in this game. Or Frozen Tempest, rather. You see the Rune Tap. Look how much that heals for Arthas, the Rune Tap. What Rune Tap is it heals Arthas for consecutive attacks, and that's super duper nice. So Illidan wants to take out the Night Camp. Oh, Jimmy Zig, when I thought he was gonna zag. Alright. Jimmy should not be able to get away. No, we did get the Night Camp. Very nice. So their golem is already dead, by the way. I'm going to push with our knights. Big Knight was kind of derping out there. But man, oh man, it does feel fun to play Arthas again. I've always liked Kael'thas as another interesting character in the World of Warcraft. I'm still trying to rack my brains in the Warcraft universe for my favorite, so-called favorite characters. That's my fault. I should have been using Cinder Ghost to disable the turrets. I was just not paying attention, but I don't think it's going to matter anyway. So Team Solo Q Mid Silliness, Navi, TSM Cloud 9 is going to indeed take the victory here. And again, I actually was really, really looking forward to playing Arthas again, and I did not disappoint. Or at least Arthas did not disappoint. Look, I even tanked the damage Lili as well as Immortal Coil. And Rune Tap. So, very, very good game overall. Thank you for watching, everyone. And let me show you the. I know that we had requests to see the post game stats, so I will show those real quick. There you go. So final total 23 and 5 deaths. I did die. Not as much as Diablo, but Diablo is pretty much supposed to die anyway. And yeah, good to be back on Arthas. Thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you had a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time here on the channel. So long, everybody.